I first came across the brand Caparison Guitars probably in around about 2001, 2002. I am a huge fan of Soilwork, the Swedish metal band, and I'd seen photos of them using these crazy guitars with like pointy headstocks and, you know, this like awesome shreddy looking, almost like an Ibanez vibe, but there was just something different about them. And I couldn't for the life of me figure out what they were called until I finally got one of their CDs and they had the little Caparison logo in the CD cover. And then I was trying to use Google and stuff to find out more info about these guitars, and it was like this big mystery, you know, every website was in Japanese and you could barely find any pictures, so it was kind of cool, you know, it was this guitar brand that not many people knew about, but these big players that I looked up to were using, and I thought, man, I'm gonna get some of these. I played quite a few different models throughout my career. The first model I ever owned was a Dellinger HGS, and then I got a TAT from Atari. It was my first endorsement guitar, and I've loved all the models that I've played, but then I joined Bring Me the Horizon, and I sort of thought the Angelus tone and body shape and everything suited the band a little more. So I actually got hold of a second-hand HGS through a friend that used to belong to one of the guys from Evergrey. And I played it, loved it, you know, it's like a beefy guitar, lots of tone, lots of body. So then I spoke to Ataru about creating some custom ones for myself. And we went with the TR body shape, which is, I think, about 0.5 centimeters thinner than the other bodies. So it's a bit lighter, a bit more agile, but still has the same body shape, thickness, tone. I went with a single coil EMG in the neck, which is something, an idea I got off the other guitarist in Bring Me the Horizon, Lee. He had a custom with a single coil, and just all the clean tones he had sounded really cool, and so I thought that'd be great, you know, just for clean and stuff like that. And then I have an EMG 85 in the bridge, which is just a ballsy pickup. And I mean, Caparison has their own pickups, but EMGs seem to complement the guitars really well as well. And I went with a maple fretboard, partly for aesthetics, because I'd never seen an Angelus with maple frets, and you know, they're kind of all the rage with a lot of metal guitars these days, and I thought I'd love to see an Angelus with maple fingerboard. And I went with a few colour options that hadn't been done on an Angelus before either, so the see-through red flame and the see-through blue flame. I wanted something sort of bright and just memorable, I guess, visually, you know, like there's so many black guitars and gunmetal grey guitars floating around the metal scene, and I wanted something just a bit, I guess, more classic looking. I use PV6505 amplifiers, Mesa Boogie rectifier oversized cabinets. I've got a few custom ones of those as well, just different Tolex and stuff like that on it. Lee and I both started using a MIDI switching system for our pedal rigs about a year ago. So we have all of our Stompbox pedals in a rack drawer, so sort of Boss, Electro Harmonic stuff. Mainly just reverbs, delays, overdrives, and electro harmonics pedal called the POG, which is sort of like an octave pedal. And we run them all through a Voodoo Lab switching system, so basically you can hit one switch and it switches four pedals off, four pedals on, changes your amp from clean to heavy, all that kind of gear.
Nice.
And yeah, pretty standard. I mean, when I was really young and first got into metal, it was sort of whatever you could access at the time. I was probably about 14, 15. The internet wasn't super strong with music sharing and that kind of thing. So I guess I started out listening to Korn, Slipknot, Machine Head. That was kind of like the heavy bands. And then from there I discovered all the Scandinavian melodic death metal bands, so Dark Tranquility, In Flames, Soilwork. The melody that really drew me into those bands, you know, that they could be so heavy and so melodic at the same time. I get a lot of questions on Twitter, Tumblr, things like that, asking about what equipment I use and what are these crazy guitars I use that kind of look like a PRS or a Gibson Double Cut, but they can't figure out what they are. And I advise anyone that has any kind of inkling to check them out to really do so. I mean, it's a pretty boutique company, and they are a little harder to find than your average Ibanez or ESP, but I think that's what makes Caparison such an attractive brand, you know? It's like the holy grail of guitars. They're really hard to find, but once you get one and you play it, you will fall in love forever. It was in Finland at a festival, and I was trying to climb down, and I needed to get down really quickly to finish the song. It was during a sample, and so I tried to do the fireman slide down the sides of the truss, and my fingers clipped one of the bars and flicked my hands off the truss. So I was basically free falling for like a second. Luckily, grabbed back on and just kept sliding down. Shat my pants too.